What's up, guys? It's Gio, and welcome back to actually kind of a new Showdown session thing I'm doing. I'm not really going to try to reach any goal this week. I'm just going to be playing ORAS OU because it's a really fun tier to play. And I guess I'll give kind of an intro to my team so far. This is not the team I meant to click on. I need to find Mega Gross is Gross. Alright, so this is a team I built around Mega Metagross, which is just a really fun team to play. Super offensive. If you guys remind me, or if I remember, I'll put a pastebin to the team down below if you guys want to try it out, because it's actually a really fun team to use because the matches move really fast. So I'll start with Skarmory, because Skarmory is the first Pokemon I chose on the team. It's a hazard lead Skarmory with Mental Herb that basically just tries to stack hazards and prevent them from being set up. With Rocks, Stealth Rocks, Spikes, Brave Bird, and Taunt. And then we also have our Spin Blocker, which is Gengar, with Sludge Wave, Shadow Ball, Will-O-Wisp, and Focus Blast. And then we also have Thundurus, who is more of a support set on this team because I don't have a Scarfer, so I need priority T-Wave. And I have T-Wave, Thunderbolt, HP, Ice, and Taunt. And then I have a Life Orb, Sheer Force, Landorus with Earth Power, Psychic, Knock Off, and Focus Blast to help me beat Chansey. And then I also have a Assault Vest Bisharp here, which is basically here to stop the Lotties from defogging. It can take HP fires pretty well because of the Assault Vest with Knock Off, Sucker Punch, Iron Head, and Pursuit. Then rounding out the team, we have our Mega Metagross, which has Meteor Mash, Bullet Punch, Zen Headbutt, and Earthquake. And just kind of acts as a ice resist for the team and cleans up a lot of teams. So if we look at where we are on the ladder, I'm not really going to go for any goal, but I just want to see where I am. I'm at 26 right now. I've dropped a little bit since last night. It was at like 1440 something, and the ladder has kind of progressed. But I'm just going to go and grab a match right here. And we find one almost immediately, which is really nice. We have a match against Loser Baby, who looks to be using this Sash spam team, because both of these I think are Sashed. I'm going to go ahead and lead Skarm, though. If he leads Lando, then I'm fine with that, and I can just taunt to stop Rocks. If he ends up leading with the Breloom, then I can just go ahead and taunt that, stop the Spore, and then stack hazards and try to prevent Skarmory from defogging. So good luck, have fun, and it looks like we are getting a little bit of lag, which is a little bit unfortunate. Let me see how many we have like 1,500 active battles. So that's probably the main reason why. Ends up leading Bisharp, which is fine. I'm just going to go ahead and taunt turn one, because I do not want this Bisharp to be able to just swords dance in my face, because I have no way to phase it, which is a little bit troubling, and I kind of have to rely on him clicking Sucker Punch so I can Will-O-Wisp him with Gengar and then outplaying him thereafter. Just taunt turn one. This thing has Mental Herb, which is really nice, because if you see like a lead Thundurus, lead Thundurus probably isn't the best example because I usually just get up Rocks against that. But if you see something like a lead Terrakion to where you know you can't be 2-hit KO'd, you can go ahead and taunt it, because if it taunts you, then you burn your Mental Herb, you taunt it so it can't taunt you back, or get up Stealth Rocks, and then you can proceed to stack your hazards. He ends up going out into Lando, though. And looking at things on his team that get Rocks, it's this or Bisharp. I'm just going to go ahead and get up my Rocks right here, as I'm assuming it's going to be Bisharp, which is his hazard setter. I'm assuming it's going to be Lando, which is his hazard setter, because he switched out there. He probably just wanted to try to get up hazards for free, but I'm going to go ahead and get a spike up right here. So he goes out into his Lando, which is fine. I'm just going to taunt again. Most Landos aren't really running enough speed to outspeed Skarmory, most defensive Rocks Landos. He ends up going out into his Latias right here, which is nice, because I can just click Brave Bird right here and pretty much just sack myself to get a free switch into something. If he HP fires, that's cool too. He ends up going out into his Lando, though, and I do 22%, so hey, I'll take it. I'm going to go ahead and hit him with a taunt right here, because I don't want him going back out into Latias and defogging away my hazards. He ends up outspeeding me anyway, but I'm actually going to double taunt right here, because I think he's going to U-turn out. If he stone edges, you know, I don't lose a whole lot by that. I just don't want him to defog away any hazards. I actually don't have any hazard support on this team, which is a little bit troubling, because I am using a Thundurus, but it's not. But that's one reason I run Life Orb on Thundurus, is because that's one reason I'm running Leftovers on Thundurus, because it makes it a lot easier to stay alive, especially for a support set, which is really nice. But I'm just going to go ahead and get up another spike, because this guy's just switching around, making Skarmory's job really easy. And at this point, like, three of his mon... Wow! Look at why Pokemon Y in the chat. He's going to go ahead and Earthquake, but I'm just going to taunt again, because I... Okay, if you want to keep going out in Latios and taking hazard damage, like, you can go ahead and do that. I don't really mind. I just get to wear down your team. He cannot knock me out with the Psy Shock. He's also Life Orbed, and I get up one more spike. I'm just going to click Brave Bird right here, because I will go down to... Nah, it's good. I will go down to the next Psy Shock, or I will go down to the recoil damage if he goes out into this. And at this point, I think I've put myself in a pretty good position, because he ends up going out into Gyarados, which is fine. My attack is so low at this point, I'm not even sure. Yeah, I don't even knock myself out with recoil. That's kind of lame. I'm going to taunt, because I'm hoping he's Adamant DD, not Jolly DD. If he's Jolly DD, he gets one up, but it looks like he's not going to get one up right here, as he ends up trying to sub in my face, and I'm not having that. 262. I'm going to taunt again, though, because I don't want him going back out in a Latios, because that would be pretty bad for me, because then he gets rid of my hazards. So, I would rather him knock me out right here, so that it makes my job a lot easier on the back end, rather than having to lose something and all that good stuff. So, I think if he knocks me out right here, I'm going to go out into my Gengar, because Gengar speed ties with Latios, and I don't think he wants to risk that, as he ends up going out into Lando T, and I'm not even sure how much more he can lower my attack, to be honest. I'm just going to taunt again, because he ends up going for the Earthquake. That's fine. I will click taunt 22 times if that's what he wants to do. Looks like he's just going to keep going. Like, I can't actually do it. Actually, I'm going to go for Brave Bird, because it will actually knock me out, which is cool. And he looks to be choice locked, and now Lando... My Pokemon Y is like Brave Bird already, but it's whatever. I'm gonna go into Bisharp right here, and I'm gonna go ahead and click Sucker Punch, because I can knock out his Lando from this range, and he looks to be like choice scarfed, even though he has rocks, but I don't think he wanted to put rocks on Bisharp, which is pretty understandable. I'm just gonna click Sucker Punch right here, though. I don't see any reason why I should not, because I can just knock him out. And so that was that, like, here I was hyping this team up for producing really quick matches, and then it just doesn't. I'm going to go ahead and click knockoff right here as he defogs, which was a good play by him, gets rid of all the hazards, but so that 20 turns just, like, completely went to waste right there, but I was able to weaken a lot of his physical threats. He ends up going out in a Loom right here. I'm just going to click Iron Head as I go down to the Mach Punch, which kind of sucks, but, you know, it's whatever. I'm just going to go out into a Gengar right here, and I'm going to click Sludge Wave, because I can do damage to something. If he goes out into Bisharp, I'll just click Will-O-Wisp, and he ends up being Sash, which kind of stinks, because, actually, he just knocks me out with the Rock Tomb, so that's actually cool. That's what I wanted him to do. Because then I get to go out into my Mega Metagross, and I get to go ahead and Mega Evolve, click Bullet Punch, because I do Speed Tie with this Breloom before I Mega Evolve, because I am Max Speed Jolly, which is kind of nice. But I think the biggest problem on his team for me right now is going to be this Bisharp, because this Bisharp actually knocks me out with the Sucker Punch, because I'm not running any HP investment. So Lando will probably be my first sack right there, as he ends up going for the Mach Punch, just getting off damage, which may actually end up mattering later, because Mega Metagross can tank one Earthquake from an Adamant Excadrill, so we'll see how much it takes from a Gyarados. If Gyarados ends up coming out, I'll probably just end up Meteor Mashing, because I feel like I just want to get damage off. If I get the attack raise, hey, it's just a bonus there. So we'll see what he ends up going out into, and hopefully it's... Man, I would really like it to be Azumarill, but I don't think it's going to be Azumarill. And I also can't let him get a Dragon Dance up with this. Basically, I can't let him leave the field with a sub or have a Dragon Dance up with Gyarados, which, like, it sounds hard in practice, or in theory, but it won't actually be too bad in practice, because I can just keep clicking Meteor Mash with Mega Metagross. And, basically, as long as he doesn't have a sub up, because then I can T-Wave him and slow him down for Lando. But ends up going out into Bisharp, which sucks, but I'm going to go out into Landorus. I'm kind of expecting the Sucker Punch right here, because I think he has to go for Sucker Punch, right? Actually, no, I'm going to go for the Earthquake. I don't want to choke. I'm going to go for the Earthquake. Please go for Earthquake Showdown. Okay, ends up going for the Pursuit. Good play. Except for the fact that it was... Oh! Dang cancel button. Man, that would have been so nice. Ends up going out to Gyarados, which is cool. He just sacks that. We'll see what he ends up going out to next, though. Ends up being Azumarill. What is Bisharp at? Bisharp's at 81. Okay. I'm going to go into Thundee. Yeah, Thundee, yes, okay. Don't get knocked out one hit. Sweet, I tank it. I'm actually going to go for the T-Wave here, maybe buy myself a free turn, I don't know. Because I think... We'll see what set he is. Oh, yes, I buy myself a free turn, which is really nice. We'll see if he's banded right here. Ends up going for the Aqua Jet, so we know he's not banded. I need one para to win. I need one para to win. I need it right now. Please, come on, come on, come on. No! Okay, so that's a good game. you know... Blame the cancel button, yes, no. How long ago? I've been recording for about 10 minutes. So we're going to call it an episode, because that's one thing that I kind of heard from you guys, is to just, like, try to keep them a little bit shorter, so that's what I'm going to do. So, if you guys did enjoy this episode of Pokemon Showdown, ORAS OU, please make sure to leave a like, because it really does help show support for the stuff that I'm doing here on the channel. And also make sure to answer today's comment question of the video, which is, do you guys like this team, and what Mega do you guys want to see me use next week? And with that, I urge you guys to subscribe if you guys are enjoying the constant content. And with that, I'll catch you on the flip-flop.